honor to be here with you. After all, I can only dance, but Mary Poppins can fly.
Well, that's true. But I can't fly without my umbrella. And anyway, we're here to talk about the beginnings of the dance, and I know you have a great deal to say about that, so go on.
All right, we'll start. Dancing began many thousands of years for a number of reasons. Number one, to communicate. Before words were spoken, people used to talk with their bodies.
Isn't it true that the dance in the old days was used in early religious rites also? Anything else that motivated dance in the early days?
Well, if you promise not to blush, I'll tell you.
Okay.
Well, the famous three-letter word, S-E-X. Yes, one of the early users of the dance.
I think it was working. We mustn't forget one more reason that people have danced, and that is they dance for no reason at all. To let off steam, to have fun. They dance for the pure joy of dancing.
All of the beautiful dances that we do come from the dancing that ordinary people have been doing in the streets and villages for thousands of years. All the steps in ballet come from five basic positions. Would you like to learn them?
I would love to, and I'm sure the audience would be very interested.
First position goes like this. Mm-hmm. Heels together, legs turned out, and that's first position. Second, you open leg to the side, arms go to the side. Third, we bring heel in front of the arch,
mm-hmm.
and arm so. Fourth, leg comes in front, parallel, arms come here. It's a very popular position to finish, for example, pirouettes, you know, finish into the fourth.
Yes.
And of course, fifth position, again, feet together, parallel, closed, toe to the heel, with arms here.
Well, those are the five basic positions.
Yes, but the beauty of the ballet is how we get from one position to the other.